What was that?
What do you mean, what was that?
Did you not hear that?
You're walking in the dark, creepy forest. It's late, very late, and you're all alone. Suddenly you hear a creak and a snap from something overhead. Was it the tree swaying in the wind? Maybe a bird moving on a branch? As you listen, your heart begins to beat faster and your breathing quickens. The way your body reacts to fear has fascinated scientists for a long time. And given that we are now approaching Halloween, we decided to visit what is said to be UK's most haunted castle. Where better to test our nerves and see how we respond to something that's meant to be scary. We divided ourselves into two groups, those who are more easily spooked, the scare team, and those who are less easily spooked, the brave team. On the scare side, we have me, Becky, scoring 80% on the scaredy cat meter. Likes insects, cozy movies, crafts, dislikes butter beans. Now we have Chris, who scores 60% on the scaredy cat meter. He likes dogs, video games, crime novels, and dislikes spiders. And on the brave team, we have Rachel, with a score of 40% on the scaredy cat meter. She likes cats, horror movies, video games, and dislikes chewing sounds. And then there's Russell, scoring the lowest on the scared cat meter at 20%. He likes scary castles, hiking, gaming, and dislikes people describing food as cheeky. Now let's get to know the team's fears and biases before we start the experiment.
I wouldn't say I'm overly scared, too frequently actually.
I'm more kind of like jumping, but I don't get spooked by that much. Probably swear a lot, so be ready with the censorship button, I think.
I'm not scared for the paranormal, but I am scared of any jump scares that happen, so anything that flies in my face.
Yeah, I am a scaredy boy.
In a context of anything like this, I've been probably one of the types in a horror movie that get killed first, because I have to go and kind of see what's going on.
Scream. I scream a lot. I have screamed a lot in the past. Moths flying, bats flying, scream, scream, scream.
I get jittery, paranoid, and quite jumpy.
I don't believe in ghosts, but I've seen four. Too long for me to explain right now.
Literally none, and I feel like I've tried to put myself in some spooky places in the past, so it'd be interesting to see if tonight changes that.
Well, we used to keep my nan's urn in a makeup drawer at my mum's house. There used to be some things that used to go bump in the night. There was a lot of explanations, but we did believe it was my nanny dolly.
A couple, yes. One of which was when I thought a ghost grabbed me in the shower. No explanation for that one.
I feel like I normally say I don't get terribly scared, so if I now start screaming on YouTube, it's going to be quite embarrassing, but see what happens.
I'm kind of excited, kind of nervous that I won't be able to sleep.
Bit nervous, but I'm not alone, so it's fine.
Yeah, it's a strange castle. Let's see if our imaginations get the better of us.
We will all be locked away in one of the rooms in Chillingham's castle, and we'll be recording our heart rate every few minutes, along with any other reactions that occur. We will see if there's a difference between the scaredy cat and the brave little soldiers.
We are currently in the dungeon of a several hundred year old castle.
And down there is like a grate. That's where they found many, many different skeletons. So this is where they used to put all of the... Oh, why is there breeze?
Okay, I'm trembling a little bit.
You're 160.
128.
See, for me, this room's kind of giving like Roman spa. If we were in towels and that was full of hot coals, it could be a luxurious experience. I think Chris meant for it to be filming us rather than the doorway.
Oh, yeah.
We used to try and escape through the latrine, which is like a grated upper mirror. Yeah, and that's how they found loads of skeletons.
That's great.
Tiny doorway. They need to work on that. I know they've got prisoners.
I'm assuming hobbits ran this castle.
I think the guys were saying that maybe these are scratch marks, although... Well, no, maybe.
And there's some scratch marks up over there.
Oh, yeah, above the door. That is a little bit disturbing.
don't know what that is.
I don't know what that is either.
You can't even hear it rain anymore.
I can hear something.
There are bodies that have been found that are remains of unknown people down there from centuries past.
Oh gosh, down in the torture room there was some, I don't know if you saw the helmets up on the ceiling, but like little goblin-y starry faces and stuff like that, so something to imagine.
Yeah. That's quite a nice space.
I know, I was thinking, my heart rate's gone down. It's proven to be, maybe it's just your soothing tones, but at the moment it's been quite a tiring experience.
The f*** was that?
What do you mean, what was that?
Did you not hear that?
How's your heartbeat?
84 at the moment.
Okay. And how's your oxygen, are you?
What does that look like?
First number.
97.
A bit strong.
Okay.
Got oxygen.
Is there anybody else in here?
Apparently not.
So I guess it's interesting then to think about why it is that the idea of paranormal things coming after me, it's so much easier to believe when I'm by myself. The second I have one other human with me, I'm like, nah, they would dare take on two of us. Yeah. I mean, do you think you'd find it any worse if you were by yourself?
I'd probably put more effort into staying relaxed and stopping my brain from going, oh, there is a grate below me.
Yeah.
What if something's calling out of it?
I just thought about seeing a face at the door.
Don't.
I can't not think of it.
We've got Rachel guarding the door at the moment, so...
Unless she's gone.
Why would you say that? Oh, no! Thanks, Rach!
It's just shadow.
You are the worst!
I am nervous, okay?
Can you remember anywhere particularly scary you ever have been? Were you getting, like, a bit freaked out?
There was a route I used to take back from work when I worked at the university, and I was walking along this path on my own at night in this blizzard, no lights at all, and guarding my face from the wind and the snow, and then stepped aside at the last second because I was about to bump into somebody, and I remember audibly saying, oh, sorry. Only to realise there was nobody there.
That is freaky.
I looked around and I remember when we were getting going, oh, cool.
Has the door opened a bit?
I'm close to the door.
Oh, it's really open.
Oh, God, no, don't.
What are we doing? 87.
Okay, so good.
It's a bit high, but...
It's just about 94 at the moment.
It's like a nice moonlit night. I do go for a walk and just kind of take in the stars.
Mm.
And I have occasionally just heard noise and found myself going,
the walk's over down.
My thoughts don't leap to, is it a ghost? It's usually, is there somebody else? Is there going to be a problem?
There's a bloody fly. I just saw it.
Yes. Okay. Okay.
Hello.
Thank you.
I'm a freak right now. I'm walking in the dark. What's going to come from that?
Yeah, more terrestrial fears.
Yeah, were you going to cut it there?
Oh. Well, I don't know, I found that strangely calming.
It's a nice chat in the dark.
I reckon, doesn't mean that I'm immune to fear, but this isn't the kind of situation that I find frightening. I think more kind of open spaces and by myself.
Feeling more vulnerable, we've got our backs against the wall here.
Yeah, that was quite nerve-wracking. Heartbeat went up to about 120 at one point.
Yeah, that was a lot. I think mine went up to 110 at the most. Oh, I didn't even realise.
Okay, let's not look at the scratched letters on the wall.
Claw marks.
Yeah, it feels quite, you know, trustworthy. That's why they use it like a prisoner's place.
I tell you what.
It keeps you in.
Squatting on this grate, there's now a breeze blowing right up my backside, so that's
Can
that's
you imagine
spooky.
Using it as a latrine, though?
Perfect. Hairy.
I started to tremble after seven minutes in. It's because you start feeling like there's something, like, you kept on seeing a face.
Hey.
Or imagining a face.
Yeah.
And then you kept on triggering me.
I'm sorry. All right.
Oh, let's leave. Yeah, we're going.
Straight on down. Yeah.
That's where I look at the face staring up at us.
Oh, God. Yeah.
we experienced different reactions being in this room. For Chris, his heartbeat rose to 125 beats per minute, which was very high compared to his actual resting heartbeat of 78. Here's what's actually going on. Fear causes a stress reaction in your body that is needed for many people to run away as fast as possible, or if worse comes to worse, fight when needed, which is also known as the fight or flight response. Acute stress or fear can cause an increase in the heartbeat, and it is due to the rise of stress hormones, cortisol, adrenaline, and noradrenaline. The heart beating faster helps to push the blood around and redirects glucose around the body, preparing the muscles for fight or flight by giving them energy. Sometimes people may scream. Screaming is a vocalization of intense emotion. People scream for all sorts of reasons, sometimes from joy and pleasure to sadness and grief, as well as fear. Screaming activates the amygdala. This is the nucleus part of the brain that helps heighten awareness. We also notice that the scared group laugh a lot. This is what is called nervous laughter. It is your brain's way of trying to deal with negative emotions or events. Back in 2019, there was a study conducted by a team of Yale researchers. They found that laughing uncontrollably reduces stress, anxiety, and most importantly, fear, and can help us turn off a negative reaction to stimulus that may make us feel uncomfortable, which is why Chris and I seem to cackle like a bunch of hyenas.
Oh no.
For some, they may experience fainting. The actual medical word for fainting is syncope. Evolutionary, you will think that if a body is in fight or flight response, then fainting is the worst thing you can do. When people see something frightening, this can activate centers in the brain which signals the spinal cord to dilate the blood vessels and signal the heart to slow down. And voila, you have a fainting person.
And on that bombshell, it's time for us to go to bed. Sadly, it is in the castle. Wish us luck.